So when we were looking at these price distribution issues, we said that we would look at the highest marks across subjects. But if we know the highest marks across subjects, surely the highest total should also be just the sum of the higher marks, don't you think?
May not be like that, because I mean, I've seen, at least when we looked at the cards, we saw that somebody, when we did the pairing, you notice?
Oh yes, yes, some people.
So some people are.
Okay, so then maybe we need to.
In fact, I would suspect that that is usually the case. I mean, people are very strong in physics and maths. There is correlation in physics and maths, I think. People do well in maths, they do well in physics, but may not do well in chemistry.
So maybe one thing would be to find out if there is a good kind of all-round student who has got, so if there is a very high total, for example, compared to the total in subjects, then there is one student, but otherwise there will be a lot of variation in the class across subjects.
Correct, correct.
So
correct.
Supposing we want to find that out, so what we want to do is compare the highest total with the highest marks total of each subject added up.
So which means that we find the highest physics mark.
Yes.
We find the highest chemistry mark.
Yes.
We find the highest maths mark. Then we add these three highest marks.
Correct.
Right. We add these three highest marks. Now this addition may not be the same as the highest total.
Correct.
Right.
So we have to then separately find.
So we find the highest total also. And then we compare the highest total with the sum of the highest marks, maths, physics and chemistry marks, and assume that difference is very large, assume it's large.
Yeah.
Then it tells you basically that, I mean, if the difference is very small, it means that the best student in the class is doing well
across all subjects.
Yeah. But if there is a difference, it tells you basically that
some students are either
good in maths and physics.
Yeah, or they're focusing on some subject.
Some subject they're focusing on, ignoring other subjects. Okay, so it's worth finding that out.
Yeah, but the only thing is that you see, I'm a bit tired. I don't want to do this four times, right? So supposing I don't have the energy to do this, right? So I can. So it's really the same thing each time, right? Except that I'm looking for
in terms of finding max, yes,
chemistry or physics or total. We are going through this thing once and finding the maximum. So maybe I can find somebody like a subcontractor. So I can outsource this to somebody.
Who'll do find the max? Who'll do the max?
Who'll do the max for me? So okay. I will tell you which max I want.
I'm the max finder.
I will tell you which
max finder
I want,
contractor.
And I will give you the cards.
You give me the cards.
And you return back the cards with the value that I'm asking for, and then I will give it to you again with a different answer question, and you return it. But for you, you're just
doing the same task
each time, except you're looking for a different.
So it's like, you know, I mean, when you say subcontractor, it's like these people who make things, right? So
yeah.
Somebody makes nuts or something like that.
Yeah.
You can give him. Make a bigger nut for me, make a smaller nut for me.
Yeah.
He makes a nut according to your specification.
For example, it could be a tailor, for example.
Tailor.
Make a yellow shirt for me, make a red t-shirt.
Or
make
with different sizes,
yeah,
right?
Different, size.
Different sizes,
yeah.
Different measurements and so on. But he will always stitch a shirt. He knows how to stitch a shirt.
Yeah.
Cut the cloth.
Yeah.
Follow the same method for making the shirt.
I give you some guidelines as to what I want, and then you adjust according to that and give it back.
Right. I understand, yeah.
So for instance, let me start this.
Okay,
so I want, for instance, to start with the subject wise. So let's start with maths. So I give you the instruction saying that, so I want the maths maximum marks. So I give you the cards. I say, please give it back to me with this value filled out.
So I can do whatever I want with the cards.
Yeah, now I'll just wait for you to come back, maybe go and have a cup of tea or something.
But meanwhile, I can do this, but
yes.
What do I need to give back to you? I give back to you the maths.
Give me back the cards and
I'll give you the cards back.
Yes.
And I can mess around with the cards.
Possibly. I don't, I'm not asking you to return the cards to me.
Because I can't tear it.
Yeah, so I need all the cards back, but maybe the order might be disturbed.
Order is disturbed. It's all right.
That's okay.
Okay. All right, let me work on this. Yeah.
So I'll just sing a song or something.
While I do this, okay.
Yeah.
So
you will of course follow the same procedure as before.
What we did earlier.
Keep track of the maximum that you have
I
seen.
I keep track of the maximum that we have seen.
Keep updating.
And so I have actually gone through the cards.
And now,
I have the maximum mark which I found for maths, which is 97. Okay.
So now you come back and tell me I have done my job.
So I have done the job. Of course, I mess around with the cards. Right, its order may have changed, but I have returned you the max marks.
So now I take this back from you. So I have the first piece in my puzzle. So I need to find out the three maximum marks in the subjects and the maximum total overall. So I will say that for maths, based on the answer that you have given me, I will note down that it is 97 because that's what you told me.
Okay.
Now I have to look at some other subjects. So supposing my next subject that I want to look at
is physics.
Is physics. Then I will change this instruction. So I will give you like this is like the tailor getting a different size.
Okay.
So I will tell you now please do the same thing, but this time give me the
physics max.
Physics max.
All right. So I do the same thing. I mean, I use follow the same procedure, which means I keep track of one maximum variable.
Yeah.
I keep updating it, looking at all the cards, right? Comparing it with the maximum.
Exactly.
And updating it when I find a higher value and so on. And I go through this procedure like this, see all the cards. And I might disturb the order, but I have done that. And the result I got is 92.
Okay. Okay. So now you give it back.
Now I give it back to you.
So notice that from my perspective, I am just sitting idle. I have really delegated this work to somebody else. And I am trusting that the answer that comes back is what I have asked for. So I have asked for something, I am giving the data with the question and I am getting back an answer with the data returned to me. Possibly the data in the sense of cards is shuffled compared to what I gave. So I cannot promise that the cards I gave are in the same order, but I get the answer I want. So
I have to believe that this is right.
So I have to believe this and write down 92 here. And finally I do the same thing for chemistry.
So presumably if I follow the same method, I'm not changing the method each time.
Yes.
The same method I'm following. So if the method is right the first time,
yes,
should hopefully it will be right the second time, and should also be right the third time. Yeah?
Exactly.
Provided it's right, huh? Yeah. To start with. Yeah. Okay. So I do the same thing. This time I'm looking at chemistry. So basically I'm comparing the chemistry. I have started with the value,
yeah,
initially zero, and then I keep comparing the value and updating it. Mm. Each time I find a card with a higher value, I update the value like what we have discussed earlier. I go through the entire list like this, right? I might disturb the order,
yes,
but they have done that. At the end of it, I come with the answer 97.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very good. So now you return this all back to me.
Mm-hmm.
So now by doing this delegation three times, I have got these three totals for the three subjects. So one interesting thing that we wanted was what would be the case if this a student had got all these highest marks.
Correct.
Right. So if we add this up, we get 286. So since these are the individual,
you can call it max total or something, right?
Yeah, so we'll just call it
total of max.
I'll call it max subject total. It's not a very nice
max one. Subject total. All right, that's fine.
So
max
we know that nobody could have got more than 286 because they could not have got more than this in any one subject.
Mm.
But the question is, did anybody actually achieve
get 286?
Right?
So
now I want to ask you separately to look at just the total, the last column in this, and answer to me the maximum that you see for that.
So again, I do the same thing.
Yeah, from your perspective.
Only thing is, instead of same procedure, instead of looking at the first, I looked at the maths mark. Then the second round, you asked me to look for physics. So I looked at the physics marks. Third round, you asked me to look at chemistry.
Mm-hmm.
Now this time, you're asking me to look at the last one, total, right? Yeah. So again, I start with zero. Compare it with 276, 270 is higher, update it, 254 is lower, don't update it, 250 lower, don't update it, like that I do. And I go through all the cards till I find the maximum. And let's say I have done that and I found the maximum to be 280 something, I think. I'm just going to look for the card. Okay, 281. This guy is the best, okay? 281 is the maximum. So 281. Okay, so I return the cards.
Yeah. So now we have messed done up. This four
messed
times.
Up.
Messed up.
But
perhaps.
But I got you the answer. 281. Yeah. All right.
So separately we have this,
which is max total.
Just the max total.
Mm-hmm.
Which is 281.
So and indeed, it's different.
As we suspected, these two are not
equal. Not the same.
Not the same. So in fact, there is a difference of 5.
5.
Which on this scale of things is not bad. So
not
this
bad.
Student who has got 281 has actually got 92 in chemistry. Whereas the maximum is 97, so it's done less than full, but not done very badly. So if this had been something like 250 or something, then it would have been
a big difference.
Something we would have to investigate,
right,
in terms of how the class is doing.
Mm.
Why are people, is three subjects too much? Are they only able to focus on two of them at a time? So these are questions that might come up if we find too much discrepancy.
So here, I mean, just let's reflect on what we have done here. What is the pattern that we are seeing here, right? So you're, we have done four times we have called something.
Yes.
Four times. So they have called, so you said subcontractor, right? So the subcontractor basically has done the same procedure.
Exactly
the same thing, four times. First did it for maths, then or whatever, whichever order. First we did it for maths, then we did it for physics, then we did it for chemistry,
yes,
and then we did it for total.
Yes.
Now the difference between these four times, when we did these four times, is each time we were looking at a different field in the card.
Exactly.
Right. The first time I looked at the maths field, next I looked at the physics field, then chemistry field, and then final round I looked at the total field. Other than looking at a different field, everything else is exactly the same.
Correct.
I had a variable which I kept, which is the max variable. I compared that max variable with the value I am reading from the card. That value could be different, right? Because it depends on whether it's maths, physics, chemistry, or total. And then if it was higher, then I update it. So, and then repeat this till I finish the cards. So this procedure is exactly the same in all the four rounds.
Yes.
So we should be able to write this nicely, right? Means in the sense, what is this? What would this be in programming? Is there a name for this?
Yeah, so we could call this a procedure.
It's a procedure.
We're talking about processes and procedures. So let's just give it a name.
Procedure.
This is a procedure.
So this is a procedure.
Which we repeatedly execute.
But each time we are doing something different.
So we have to pass. I mean, so the procedure has some set of instructions.
It has a set of instructions. It follows.
But obviously, if it does the same thing every time, it's useless. So
okay.
It must be adjusting to something.
Okay.
And in this case, we are adjusting to it by giving it a different.
The field name.
Field name. So there is.
So you're passing the field name to this procedure.
Yes. To make it adapt to that particular.
So this business of passing, is there a name for this in programming? I mean, do you call it something?
Yeah. So I think we normally call it a parameter.
Parameter. So the procedure has a parameter,
yes,
which is the field that you want to look at.
Yes.
And this parameter you're giving me. So you gave it to me by writing,
yes,
in your cards.
So I wrote
chemistry,
the name
maths.
Of the sun, yeah.
You wrote chemistry or taught physics or whatever it is. So you gave me the parameter to look at, the field to look at as a parameter to the procedure.
And you gave me back.
And max, I guess, is the name of the procedure.
Yeah.
Max is the procedure.
Yeah.
Max is the name of the procedure.
Yes.
Chemistry is the name of, or physics, or
yeah,
total is the name of the procedure. Parameter.
Yes. So we could write it like this. So we could say that I ask you to compute the total.
Mm-hmm.
And like we have in maths, we use these arguments, right? So we say square of x or sine of x or something. So I can write the parameter inside. So I'll say total of maths. So this is like.
Or in this case, you're doing max. The process is max.
Sorry. Yeah, max of.
So you can say max of maths.
Max of maths.
Huh.
And then you come back to me with an answer.
With an answer.
So 92 or 97 in this case.
Similarly, you can ask max of physics,
yes,
max of chemistry.
Yeah.
Or max of total.
Correct.
So max is the, it's like,
yeah,
a, oh, it's like a function in what
we've
seen.
So you
in.
Think of it as a function, except that the what you are operating on, so if I say max of physics, right? So what you're operating on normally when you're doing a function is that you're looking for a over a range of inputs. So here our inputs are the cards and the parameter is telling
so
us.
So there is some data set on which you gave me. You are a contractor. You have a data set, you shared this data set with me.
Yes.
As a subcontractor, I got access to your data set.
Hmm.
So, and you have delegated this work to me. So, it's a delegation, right?
Yes.
You delegated this work to me as a subcontractor. I have access to your data set.
Hmm.
You gave me access to your,
yes,
data set. If you didn't give me access to your data set, I can't do anything. And, but then I have, when you wrote this contract with me, we also agreed basically that if I mess up with this data, of course, I can't tear it. I can mess up with the order.
Yes.
You don't have a problem with that.
Yes.
So if I return it to you in a different order, you don't complain,
yeah,
and
as
say.
As long as you don't damage a card or change any of the fields or anything, you don't update anything in that, it's fine.
It's fine. So we agreed on this, how I will return this data set which we share, how I will return, what state I will return it. We agreed on that. And then we agreed basically that there will be a parameter you will keep changing.
Yes. And for
in
that
this case, there is only one parameter.
Yeah. And you will give me a value which represents.
And I will return the value. One value,
yeah, which
represents.
Which we agree what it means.
What it means, we agree.
Yeah.
So this is a procedure with a parameter.
Yes.
So parameterized procedure. Okay.